The Lake District is one of Britain's most popular national parks. The beautiful scenery attracts close to 9 million visitors each year, who come to explore the mountains, valleys, lakes, and settlements. The main activity enjoyed by visitors is walking. There are lots of places to walk amongst the Lake District fells, and there are many adventures to be had, including walking up England's highest peak, Scafell Pike. It is estimated that over 7 million people walk in the Lake District each year. That's a lot of footsteps, and over time, this has caused a problem. The heavy use of popular routes, in combination with the Lake District weather, has a big impact on the fragile mountain environment, causing small footpaths to turn into large erosion scars. Grass and other vegetation are very good at holding soil together despite the heaviest rainfall, strongest wind, and coldest snow. When walkers trample on the vegetation, the soil is exposed and open to the elements. Rainfall washes soil away, and gradually footpaths turn into channels for water to run down, becoming deeper over time. These channels are difficult to walk in, so people walk to the side. This process is repeated until several channels merge and form a large scar in the landscape, often visible from miles away. The soil ends up in lakes, where the excess silt causes problems for fish and other species. The erosion of peat soil releases carbon into the atmosphere. Eroded paths are not only unsightly and difficult to walk on, they can also lead to habitat loss and damage to the archaeological and natural history of the Lake District fells. Paths have been repaired in the Lake District for over 30 years. In the 1990s, the main conservation organisations in the area identified paths with the most severe erosion and came up with a plan to get them fixed. The funding so far has come from the Heritage Lottery Fund, local organisations, businesses, and public donations. This has enabled the Fix the Fells project to restore 160 paths, but there are 60 more still to fix. Path repair should blend into the landscape. Preventative measures are used on paths that are just beginning to show signs of wear. When erosion has become too bad, the paths need to be restored. These traditional techniques use naturally occurring materials. The methods range from stone pitching and soil inversion to more novel techniques like using sheep fleeces. Horses sometimes help out, and helicopters are used to drop bags of stone on the fells. The skilled and experienced path workers are out in the most remote corners of the fells in all weather conditions. Fix the Fells uses a combination of full-time upland path repair teams and a small number of specialist local contractors.
Most people think we're building the footpaths to make it easier for them to walk up the fell. And we have to point out that's not the case. What we do is basically we repair damage caused by initially feet and then water. So we're basically preventing erosion. Some jobs obviously are high up on the fell with difficult access, and it can take 2 hours to walk in before you even start work. And what we tend to do is try to carry all our tools in on day one and store them on the fell side. We carry in the essentials, i.e. food and our first aid kits and what we need day by day. Depends on the footpath, depends on the ground conditions, whether it's rocky, whether it's soft material. But two of us working for a day on a difficult path might get 2 metres of footpath done. On a lower path, easier working conditions, you may get double that. You may get 4 metres done in a day. So if a path contract is for 100 metres, it's a fair number of man days to fix it up. No, the job itself is excellent. I mean, you can't get a better office than this. You know, we get a number of comments from people who come past and say, oh, rather you than me, or you've got a job on there. And you know, you say, well, yeah, but people are coming here to walk in the footpaths and to appreciate the scenery, and we work here, so we get the best of both worlds.
There are also over 100 Fix the Fells volunteers who take part in regular practical work parties across the fells. The volunteers are keen fell walkers, and many see this as an opportunity to give something back to the places which afford them so much pleasure. Fixing fell paths is expensive, so your help is greatly appreciated. By the end of 2011, around £5.5 million will have been spent on upland path restoration. There are still paths needing repair, and lots need preventative help. Path repair can cost up to £150 per metre. By donating to Fix the Fells, your money will go directly towards protecting the Lake District mountain environment. You can donate from wherever you are through the Fix the Fells website. When you are in the Lake District, support local businesses that help fix the fells. Look out for Fix the Fells donation boxes. You can help care for the fells by walking responsibly. Take the following steps. Place your feet thoughtfully. Every single footstep causes wear and tear on the environment. Don't take shortcuts. Water will soon follow your tracks and start to cause erosion scars. Keep to the path's surface. Slow-growing mountain plants are particularly at risk to trampling, and walking along the side of worn paths will widen them faster. Do not build or add to cairns. Removing stones from paths can make erosion problems worse. Paths need stones more than cairns do. Remember, there may be only one of you, but another 7 million pairs of feet tread the paths each year in the Lake District. You can find out much more information about Fix the Fells and make a donation at our website, www.fixthefells.co.uk.